Everyone. In this video, I'm going to be drawing a mermaid for you. And as you can see, I've already started my framework for the upper body. And I'm going to carry on. And start on the tail, I think. A few interesting things about mermaids, for those of you that don't know. A mermaid is a mythical, legendary aquatic creature with the upper body of a human and the tail of a fish, which I'm going to draw here. Now, mermaids appear in folklore in all sorts of cultures around the world. They're in paintings, books, films, you name it. Mermaids, also known as sirens in Greek mythology, were associated with perilous events such as floods, storms, shipwrecks, and drownings. They're actually quite dark and mysterious creatures. Not quite accurate to the Little Mermaid movie. It's believed they would lure in sailors with their beautiful singing and drag them down to the depths. So we've got her tail coming round. I've got her in an upright position. I'm going to give her a nice big fan on her tail. Like so. Just a guideline, which I'll come back to later. There we go. So now she's got her body. I'm going to use this middle guideline just so I can get all the parts in position. Just going to rub this out and work on the top half. Okay. Now I'm just going to start some scales down the bottom here. So I'm going to make a V shape, like so. And now comes the time-consuming part. to draw in tiny little circles. And once I'm happy with where they are, I shall rub out the guideline, and that will be the top of the tail for my mermaid. I'm going to do a couple of half circles on the top line. So that it blends nicely. Okay. A couple of half circles. So that her tail actually looks 3D on the outside, like so. Okay. To rub out my guideline. Okay. There's the start of my tail. Okay. I'm going to do the same thing on the chest. Kind of like scales rather than actual clothing. Okay. Up this side. Okay. I'm just going to carry that on. I think I'm going to bring her hair down. So, okay, yep, I'm happy with that. I'm just adding some more scales for effect, so they actually look like they're part of her body. Other myths about mermaids or merpeople are that blood had healing powers, as well as a mermaid's kiss. Also, in some mythology, it was believed that if a merperson or merfolk came out of the water, they would change and sprout legs instead of a tail. How cool is that? At the moment I'm drawing in the spines for the tail. There we go, that's better. Give me a rough idea of where things are going to go. Okay, so comes out and then curl around that way. Like, I think I need to make that a bit smaller. Not entirely happy with that, but again, they're just guidelines, so I can go over them at a later date. So, I'm gonna have her wrapped in some seaweed. The other arm, I think. Just down there and wrap it around like so. Okay, lovely. So you can see my mermaid starting to take shape. some shading, I think. Okay. So I'm just adding the spines to her tail. And just giving it a little shading in there. So you can probably see that I've started adding the extra details. I finished the hair. I've given her some sort of seaweed around her arms. And I'm just going to be working on her tail for this next part. Okay. So I want it a little wider on the outside and tapering inwards. So let's rub out these guidelines. Okay. Okay. Add some little spines there. A bit of shading around the edges. So I think this one's going to come out here, so it's similar to the other side. And then I'm going to tweak this line here, I think. Better. I like that. Okay. There we go. Just do some light shading around the joints and a few little just thin lines that are a bit lighter. There we go for texture. Okay. That's that side done. So I think I'm going to have to do this in parts or do a speed drawing so that you can see the finished product. But for now, I'm just going to show you a few of the elements in this video. before I do the other side, I think I'm going to add a little bit along the edging. Okay. Okay. So I'm going to do the same thing on this side. Have my darker lines for the joints. Shade it in a little. Make sure I add my spines in, like so. And my thin lines going up the tail, like that. Okay. Let's just zoom you out a bit first. So you can kind of see she's starting to build up slowly. So this is going to be the end of part one, and I will upload part two next week, so you can see me finish her off, and maybe we might be able to add some colour to this picture. So I hope you enjoyed my little ramble. And I will see you all very soon.